season for our pets as ticks become more active again across many areas of eastern Australia. For good advice on how to deal with them, let's welcome Bondi Vet, Dr. Lisa Chimes. Welcome back to the show. Let's start with a warning for Melbourne owners, Melbourne pet owners first, because a very deadly type of tick has made its way to Melbourne.
The paralysis tick has now officially been found in Melbourne.
That doesn't sound
good. That's really bad.
It's really scary because Melbourne was always the area that was free of this horrible pest, and now we've had cases right in Melbourne. Don't know how they've got there, but the ticks are spreading.
They've probably taken their pets up north on holiday and then they've come back with them.
Exactly, because ticks can travel back on your clothing or on your pets, and they can set up a new little ecosystem in different areas. So it's pretty scary. And also with the weather staying warmer than it has been in previous years, that's what ticks like.
And it's so confusing too, because when I was a kid at school, getting a tick was a good thing.
Really? Really?
I'm sorry, Australia. I'm sorry, Australia.
Because it makes me feel itchy just thinking about them. How can we protect our pets from them?
Well, the big problem is the paralysis tick. Now, what it does is it's got a toxin in the saliva, and as it's feeding off your pet's blood, it's injecting that toxin into their system, and that paralyses them. So the best thing you can do is check your pet every single day.
Every day?
And that's why I've brought Nelson in, because I thought I can show you
Don't take it from me.
Denise wants to keep your dog.
And outside of Victoria, are there other areas of Australia that this is happening as
well? Well, the eastern seaboard is the main location, so Queensland, New South Wales, but they can go as far inland as the Blue Mountains. So they really can go anywhere. And the problem is that once a tick starts feeding on your pet, it can take, say, 3 days, up to a week, to start to notice that there's something wrong. So that's why checking them every single day is going to be one of the most important things you can do.
But how do you check them?
All right, so ticks like the warm areas. So most of them come around the head and the neck. So I've seen so many ticks curl up here around a dog's lips, around their eyes, inside the ears, under the neck, between the paws. And when they start feeding, they're really tiny, and sometimes you can only notice them just by feeling.
They feel like a little tiny pin, don't
like
they?
A little pimple,
the top of a pin.
Because Ernie used to have them, didn't he?
And it was a bugger to check too.
What do you do if you find a tick then? And how do
you get them off?
So what you're doing is you're just moving your fingers all around your pet, because they really can go anywhere. If you feel any little bumps, you have a look.
Yeah.
Anything that you think is worrying, just contact your vet straight away. So if you do find a tick, or you find something that you think looks like a tick, don't hesitate to contact your vet. They'll take it off for you. Don't do it yourself.
Sometimes you can leave the head in of the tick.
Exactly. So rather get your vet to show you how to do it. You can get special tick removers, and once you're comfortable with that, then you may be able to do that in the future. The other thing is keep your pet really calm, because sometimes the signs of tick paralysis can be really subtle. So they might just be a bit lethargic, or they might vomit, or they might make a funny voice. Their voice might have changed.
So basically, if they start behaving like Jono, call your vet.
What about tick poisons, sort of the preventative stuff? Do they actually work?
In recent years, there are some really great products. There's one called NexGard that's a once-a-month beef-flavoured chew for dogs.
Is that any good, or is that fleas?
Look, all these products do work, but none of them are 100%. So it's also important that you use the right product in cats too, because we don't want
to ask, can cats get ticks as well?
Cats can definitely get ticks, and there are products like Frontline that can be used every 3 weeks in cats that can help. But both dogs and cats need to be checked every day. There's nothing
really
better than checking them. And you combine that with a preventative, that's the best thing you can do.
And can these ticks attack humans as well?
Yeah, they can. I mean, we're not as affected. We're not as affected by paralysis as pets are, but there have been reports of people getting really, really sick from paralysis ticks too. So it's just...
They're revolting.
I feel strangely uncomfortable all of a sudden.
It's really good advice. Thank you so much, Dr. Lisa Chimes, everyone.
And thank you, Nelson. Thank you, Nelson.
Our Nelson, of course. You're going to have to wrestle him away from
Look at him. I love him.